Welcome to the Constitution, explained through music. For each article, section, and amendment, we're going to tie in a song to make it more memorable. First off, let's go over the preamble. The preamble doesn't actually execute any laws. It just explains why the Constitution exists. It explains why we have justice, why we have unity, why birds suddenly appear every time you are near. Well, not that last part, but the other two things for sure. After the preamble, the Constitution quickly jumps into the Articles. Article 1 of the Constitution details the three branches of government and specifically focuses on the legislative branch, including its powers and limits. The article has 10 sections? 10
hecking
sections? That's too much. I mean, too much heaven, of course, because I just love government so much. Anyway, let's jump into it. Section 1 of Article 1 establishes the legislative branch as the Congress, which controls the laws, so no law breaking. Section 2 establishes and limits the House of Representatives, which is the lower house of Congress. Ah, don't feel bad, House of Representatives. Just because you're less cool and attractive than Senate doesn't make you unimportant. Or maybe it does. I'm not entirely sure.
I could never see tomorrow.
Section 3. Section 3 establishes the upper house of Congress, the Senate. The upper house is cooler than the lower house by default. Section 4. Section 4 basically details that every state elects its members in their own way. So each state goes their own way, I guess. Section 5. Section 5 covers the fact that a minimum number of Congress members need to be present for a meeting to continue. If there aren't enough members, Congress needs to stop. Section 6. Section 6 establishes that members of Congress can't hold other jobs in office, can't be detained while traveling to and from Congress, and need to be paid that sweet, sweet
money.
Section 7. How a bill becomes a law. Oh, this one's easy. There's already a song that perfectly explains this.
Oh, I hope and pray that they will, but today I am still just a bill.
Section 8. Section 8 details the powers of Congress. The power to regulate state commerce, the power to create, like, post offices and stuff, and the power of law. Section 9 is basically the opposite of Section 8. While Section 8 details the powers of Congress, Section 9 details the limits of Congress. This includes the limit of not being able to take money from the Treasury, the limit of not putting any states above others in the making of laws, and the limit of love. Okay, I guess it doesn't really work with that one. Section 10. Section 10 details the limits on states. Hey, Ohio, want to declare war? No! Yo, California, want to print money? No! Oregon, my man, want to lay any imposts or duties on imports or exports that isn't absolutely necessary for executing its inspection without the consent of Congress?
No.
And those are all the sections of Article 1. All right, cool. One article down, six to go. Article 2. Article 2 establishes the executive branch, also known as the President of the United States of America, not to be confused with the 90s alternative pop rock band, the Presidents of the United States of America. No, Chris Ballew and his boys sadly don't hold any similar powers to the actual President of the United States of America. Section 1. Section 1 basically jams in as much information about the President as it possibly can. It sets up the Electoral College, defines a term as 4 years, disallows the president's salary from changing, and requires that the president is at least 35 years old, a natural-born citizen, and has been a U.S. resident for at least 14 years. It's a lot, and too much to be fit into one section. I mean, too much heaven. Wait, I already made that joke. Huh. Section 2. Section 2 details the many powers of the president, like the power of love. Dang, I've used that one already, too. Have I run out of songs? Section 3. Section 3 is a nice section, detailing the duties of the president like carrying laws out, making Congress suggestions, etc. It's specific. It's detailed. It's nice and easy. Section 4 is nothing like Section 3. Section 4 is a problem child. A problem child that needs to be more like its brother Section 3 and be more specific. You see, while Section 4 technically goes over the president's powers to impeach, it's super vague, which leads to confusion and multiple interpretations and pain and... And that is all of Article 2. On to Article 3, which goes over the last of the three branches, the judiciary branch. Section 1. Section 1 establishes the highest court, the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court is a 1960s Motown group made up of singers like Diana Ross, Mary Wilson... Oh, wait. That's just the Supremes. Section 2. Section 2 guarantees criminals the right to a trial, sets up original jurisdiction, among other things. I honestly can't think of any song to tie into this section, so you're just gonna have to listen to the sound of silence.
Hello, darkness.
Oh, well, that's not what I meant, but that's a song, so that works.
I've come to talk with you.
Section 3. Section 3 defines the crime of treason, which basically can be committed by working with America's enemies or waging war with America. And that makes sense, because after all, war is good for
absolutely nothing.
And that is all of Article 3. Article 4 is all about states. Section 1. All states have to honor the laws of other states. I could easily shoehorn in that one song from like Milan about honor, but that's pretty tacky, so I'm not gonna do
that. You'll bring honor to us.
Section 2 guarantees that all citizens are treated equally in court as
everyday people.
Section 3. Section 3 details the control of federal laws as well as how new states are admitted, just in case there are any new kids in town.
The new kid in town.
Section 4. Section 4 ensures people a representative democracy and guarantees states protection from invasion. However, the federal government apparently doesn't protect states from the British invasion. Ha! Get it? And that is all of Article 4. On to Article 5. Article 5 is all about amendments. It focuses on how to edit the Constitution through amendments, which can lead to
changes.
With that, now seems like a good time to take a break from articles to focus on all 27 current amendments. And first up, the Bill of Rights. Ready? Let's go. The First Amendment gives people the rights to all religion, free speech, and press. Pretty much all the music used in this presentation is possible because of the First Amendment. The Second Amendment is fairly controversial, and it basically says you have a right to a gun. Or as the Constitution puts it, the right to bear arms. However, I'm not sure why anyone would want bear arms. That is, unless they are a bear, of course.
Get your dairy.
The Third Amendment basically says that you don't have to let soldiers live in your house anymore. So, when British troops invite themselves in and crash on the couch like a disappointing sibling, you have the right to tell them to
get up off of that thing and dance to do better.
Well, minus the dancing part. You can't really force people to dance. The Fourth Amendment requires police officers to get a warrant if they want to search a person, search property, or
do the dance.
Or
make a love. Get down
that. The Fifth Amendment states that you cannot be tried for the same crime if you've already been found. The Sixth Amendment guarantees an accused person a speedy trial with an impartial judge.
He didn't do it. He wasn't there. He didn't want.
The Seventh Amendment allows a court case to commence between two parties. It takes two for this type of trial to happen, naturally. The Eighth Amendment basically bans cruel and unusual punishment.
Don't be cruel.
The Ninth Amendment is the original catch-all backup plan. It straight up says, like, hey, we probably forgot some rights, so some more unwritten rights probably exist.
You're the best around.
It's pretty genius. The Tenth Amendment states that all powers not held by the federal government goes to the states. Okay, seems like a lot of power to be bestowed upon states, so
that it's strange.
Alright, Bill of Rights down, which is the 10 original amendments of the Constitution. And with these next 17 amendments, I think we ought to go for a speedrun round. Featuring footage of kittens. Let's jump into it. The 11th Amendment prohibits any non-resident of a state to sue that state. Also, foreigners cannot sue the U.S. itself. After all, that move would be
cold as ice!
The 12th Amendment scratches the old system of the vice president being whoever gets the second most votes and separates the voting of the president and the vice president. This amendment basically fixes the gaping hole of the previous system.
I'm fixing a hole where the rain
Latin.
The 13th Amendment prohibits slavery.
You don't own me.
I am sorry. The 14th Amendment, being established after the Civil War, punishes the Confederacy by giving slave citizenship with full rights on a state level. Yeah, give people rights. I'll show them, I guess.
Another one bites the dust.
The 15th Amendment makes it illegal to deny people the right to vote based on race.
You gotta fight for your right!
You knew I had to use that song eventually.
Yeah!
The 16th Amendment allows Congress to place federal taxes.
'Cause I'm the tax man.
The 17th Amendment changes senators to be elected by popular vote and also created a process for replacing senators. Have fun! The 18th Amendment made the distribution and consumption of alcohol illegal.
Can't buy me
alcohol. The 19th Amendment made it illegal to deny women the right to vote. The 20th Amendment sets up the date that the president takes office as January 20th and sets the day legislative positions take offices as January 3rd. It also forces Congress to meet at least once a year. Only once? Sounds lonely.
One is the loneliest number.
The 21st Amendment repeals the 18th Amendment. Amendment 22 limits the president's term to a maximum of 2 terms of 4 sweet. Amendment 23, Washington, D.C. residents may vote for representatives to vote in the Electoral College. And honestly, how does one connect a song to that? Amendment 24, no taxing on voting. What a miracle.
I believe in miracles.
Amendment 25 clarifies the line of succession of the president. For example, the vice president takes over if the president dies.
Everybody dies.
The 26th Amendment lowered the voting age to the drafting age, which was 18. The reasoning for this was at the time, at 18 years old, you were
old enough to kill, but not for voting.
Amendment 27 states that any laws that alter the pay of legislators have to take place after an election. Yeah, guys, you have to wait for that man.
I'm waiting for my man.
And speed run over. Alright, back to the articles. Article 6. Article 6 sets the Constitution as the supreme law of the land. I'm not sure why they waited so long to write that part down. I mean, like, shouldn't it have been in the beginning? Then again, what do I know?
Absolutely nothing!
Well, that's just me. And recycled. Article 7 details that in order for the Constitution to go into effect, 9 out of the 13 states have to accept it. The article only really applied to when the Constitution was first set up, so it was only really used once in a lifetime. And that's everything. I wish I could have crammed in more Beatles songs. Less than 10 just isn't enough. So to send this video off, I'm going to play all of the Beatles songs I wish I used. At once.